My name is NITIN HARSH, founder of Rhythms of Rajasthan. So I used to hang out on a stop sign on the railway crossing and used to hung up in a rhythms. So I still have the memory in the rhythms. When I used to walk, I have to walk in a rhythm. I didn't know that's why it's happening with me. But somewhere the three idiots elements in the DNA was there, so I just started making a story in my family that's now computer is my dream. Bachelor of Computer Application, first semester went, second semester went, and I was just fed up with the computer. I was not getting any rhythms in computer. Then I said this, oh, the computer, what the computer can do, anything else. Oh, let's start a video editing. Music and video editing. Then I joined a 6 months diploma course of video editing and graphics effects. And surprisingly, and you can say the coincidentally, I met one of my common friend who used to work in an organization called Rupayan in Jodhpur. And there was a editing, non-linear editing table was free. And they was looking up for someone, a video editor. Then I went there. I was very eager to join because as soon as I want to get my own editing table. Then when I slowly when I got to know that there was one more surprise, there is also camera. You can use the camera. So then Komal Kothari started me to sending in the villages. So I was more and more just interested in the editing. But then when I started using the camera, then suddenly when I listened first time Rajasthani folk music, I got the rhythms. Oh, this is what I was looking from a long time. Now, because I have my own camera, my editing table, and a lot of freedom. So in just 2 years, in direction of Komalda, I recorded almost 500 hours of video recording in the archives. And I started sending emails to the musical festivals, whoever the interested and all. I created, and in 2005 for the video contents, I traveled almost like 28 days in summer, in June, in Western Rajasthan to create a documentary on the dedication of Komal Kothari. And that happens, my first documentary, Rajasthan, A Musical Journey. That has no dialogue, it's all the music, dance, puppetry, acrobatics, and everything is in the documentary without any commentary. You can just experience the documentary, travel documentary. First time when I visited Tehran on the airport, I didn't know anything about the airport. Everything I followed with my musician because my musicians were more experienced than anyone in my, even in my family, anyone. They know this is in Marwadi, you have to do immigration here, sound check here, security check here and all. When we performed first show in Tehran at Wahdat Hall, I still remember after the concert, audience was just surrounding in our van. They were wanted to see the artists, especially the hands, how they are playing the kartal. Oh, is there any glue in the hands, how they are playing very freely. And next day, I got two national TV interviews, and everybody was just throwing me questions because there was a big news in the next day newspaper. So they were asking me a lot of questions about their background. Then I realized my duty, that because not only the performing on the stage is important, sharing the right knowledge, background, all the details about the folk ragas, folk songs, it's very important. Then I started seriously, and then we got that journey started, and it's gone almost like 22 countries. We performed more than 65 international shows, including a grand performance in Hollywood Bowl, which is the biggest amphitheater in Los Angeles. After Oscar winning by A.R. Rahman, he conceived the musical night. He conceived the musical night Journey to India, and he decided that no journey can complete without Rajasthan. So his concert we opened. And I still remember when we were in Los Angeles in a green room, he asked us to visit in his green room, and he said, you guys have to open our program because the Rajasthan has a vibrancy and the rhythms. So start, open my show with a good energy and it will be fantastic night. And it was a very fantastic night. 23,000 audience was there, full pack. And then this process was still going on. Recently, we've been traveled in countries like China, Shanghai, 2 times in Germany. So, but now I'm trying to get an audience in not a commercial way. Like I did it very experimental in just New Year in my Tivri village. I organized a New Year events. It was not on 31st night, on the 1st of January. I organized, that was also my 17th anniversary of my father. And that time I realized that I should have only implement the traditional method of publicities. I just hired a auto rickshaw with the bhompus, and he wandered the whole village, and every villagers, they got to know this after one day or 2 days, this thing is happening. And that's, luckily there was some international groups who worked with me, like European dancers, a Italian bansuri player was also here, and I explained them the idea that you will get fantastic audience. You will never seen, but in very few days of work. And in 2 days, I organized the show, and I was very worried. I was not sure that the audience will come to listen in the village. On the 1st of January, it was very freezing night. We were hardly can stay there on the open area, but I seen 50 or 60 villagers, they came and like in shawls, and they were standing there. And that was a good sign that maybe some few more will come. 7 o'clock we started the performance, and 7:30 or 8:30, it will like 500 people came. And by the 9:30, it was whole full pack, and the people, the audience was sitting on the rooftop of nearby houses. Now the globalization time, they started performing. They were used to perform for the traditional patrons, but now, because they are performing globally, they have a global patrons. But this affects very seriously on their folklore. They are losing lots of songs, because what's happened in a commercial shows, they are bound to sing a particular songs, because people usually get this Nimbura, Kesariya Balam and all. But their forefathers, especially their grandfathers, they used to sing 200, 300 songs. But now new generation is just limiting their folklore in just 10 or 15 songs. This is a negative shade of globalizations. That's why I wanted to start this project doing village shows. It is very less budget, but you can sing variety of folk songs related, because village audience knows their traditional language. Whatever they sing, they will enjoy. That's the show. And especially nowadays, they started demanding a lot of Bollywoods, but still the village has the real audience. That's the one idea I have. The second idea, which gonna be, well, my very focused project, in 2014, I got a chance to perform and to bring the traditional musicians in Germany's oldest festival called Klangwelten. It was 25th ceremony of that festival, and that's the city by city tour festival. We used to travel in a caravan, a small van where we can sleep, and then we have to travel in small towns and perform, and next day. So 28 cities we perform in Klangwelten festival. Out of the 28 shows, 8th time we perform in church. So that time I was, suddenly I got a, I don't know, idea. I was listening their music, and that time I did a Facebook update also, that time, that me, as a Hindu Brahmin, I brought this Sunni Muslim Rajasthani musicians performing in church and singing Krishna bhajan. And that time I was amazed about this idea. The music has no boundary. Nobody was even know that they are the Muslims, and I am the who brought that is a Hindu Brahmin, a Catholic, the Christian audience was listening, and in the church, and everybody was enjoying clapping on Radha Krishna bhajan, and it was a very sacred idea. And then I realized, if a society, a country, a world should learn, they should learn from this tradition. They are the Sunni Muslim performing for Hindu Jajman, the patrons, from generation to generation. They sing more Hindu bhajan, Hindu songs, bana, bani, all the our social celebration songs. But nobody noticed that. That time I realized, and I said I should start and I should create a project where we should perform more and more in church and mosque. And also we also sing the Sufi and the Hindu bhajans and traditional songs. So that was the very brief story of my journey. But anyway, I came to Kota, but not on that way. The TEDx brought me here, so the Kota is good for me, finally. Thank you very much. I would like to invite on Kartal, Zakir Khan Langa, on Dholak Barkat Khan Langa, and my youngest Sarangi player, Aslam Khan Langa.